Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the world of Wayne, and we've now got Box 6, the Agora Models release, a build the Mitsubishi A6M Zero Fighter. Now, if you remember where we got to last time, we're going to be doing some more on the starboard wing. We're going to be doing some ailerons, and we've got lots of electrics to do. Let me just show you where we're up to. If you remember in the last time, we put all of these ailerons here, and we pretty much completed the port wing over here. We still got this wing left to do. Now, we have already put some of the electrics in for that wing, looking that, but we're going to be building onto that in this stage here. We had already built the gear for that as well, which looks like that. And finally, if you remember this from quite a few packs ago, we've got the cockpit here and we've got a battery box, which is going to play heavily in this pack because we're mounting that, doing lots of electric testing. So if you want to get this for yourself, I've put the link down here to the Agora Models website. You can get this all the way from pack one. Now, if you go over there at the moment, you will also see the Super Snake, the Cobra, the Terminator, the Bismarck, the Routemaster Bus, the Jaguar E-Type, the New York fire truck, and this build. Is that eight at the moment? Oh my God, eight builds at the moment. But you can see all of those at the Agora Models website. But without further ado, let's get cracking. So these are the parts that come in stage 46. We're gonna be attaching the Type 99 Mark II 20mm machine gun to the right-hand landing gear. And that looks just like this. So the first thing we need to do is we need to bring over the wing here. Now I'm trying to find a part from the last stage that I had, which I've got in here, and it's what I'm looking for. I'm going to tip this all out, is this little tiny bit of plastic here, which is quite difficult to show you. So what I'll do is I'll put it in some tweezers just so you can look like what that is. There we go, that looks like that. Now this is going to be going over this hole just here. So if you look on the top camera, I'm going to put it over the hole just there. That's going to lift up the switch that's going to be going on top of that. Now I'm going to get these silver screws out ready because this is going to be quite a tricky move to get the switch, which looks like this, installed without moving that washer. Now when we put this on, you want the switch parts here. Just these buttons, just checking they work, to be upright. Put this on like this. Excellent, make sure that washer doesn't move. And then we're gonna hold it in with the silver screws that we've got here. So one this side and one the other side here. And then we're gonna make sure this cable is tidy. They've got the cable going into this section here and then out the hole that you can see just at the bottom there. So we're just gonna go out here, push that through so it's nice and tidy. There we go, that's the switch installed. Now we're going to be putting the landing gear in, and basically we're going to be lining up these two holes here, that's what the landing gear looks like, into these two holes at the top here. So this is going to be going in like this, so that then the gear here fits perfectly flush on top of those switches, just like that. Now you should have some screws from the last stage for this, because they are slightly different. You've got a smaller, thinner screw, which is going into the top, which is a 4404. And there is a chart later on that I'm going to put on there to show you what all of these look like. And then the one at the bottom, slightly bigger, which is a 4402. That's now in securely. We could put that to one side because we're now going to be doing the Type 99 Mark II 20mm machine gun, and we're going to be putting an LED in here. Now the LED, just like the other side, is going into this little trough down there. Now to get it in there, we're going to need to bend this right close to the LED so it looks like that. That way you'll be able to get this all the way in without the wire impeding. Now what I'm going to use is some flat nose tweezers here just to put behind there so I can push that so it goes fully into there, making sure that the wire's coming out the side. Now I've pushed that in as far as it goes. As you can see, it holds itself in there, but that's all done. Bring the wing back over here, and this is going to be going into this port just here. Now what's going to happen, this lug here is going to go into that hole, and that should pretty much line up the rest of the gun for you, just like that. You want to make sure that clips right in there so it's flush. It does take quite a lot of pushing, I have to say. Just tidying this wire up here, because that, I'll show you from this side, is all there is to do in that stage. Now in stage 47, a couple of bits here. We've got the motor, we've got a cog for that motor here, because we're going to be attaching the right landing gear motor. So quite simply, all we do first is just untangle this. There we go. And we're going to be putting this cog on the end. As you see, we've got a little cross thread across at the end, just going to match the shape of that cog. Make sure it's pushed all the way in there. Bring over the wing again, looking like this. Once again, the lead for this is going through the same hole that we've been putting everything else at the moment. So I'm going to get that all the way through. Excellent. Make sure this wire is down here, because now the motor is going to be going on top of it. So just like this, and that sits in there like that. Now we've got a gear that we had from stage 45 and a shaft here, which is going to go through that. And that's going to piece together between this gear and that gear there. So we need to make sure that it's engaged fully into that. So I'm just looking at that. That is fully engaged on all those motors there. I don't know if I can demonstrate it, because obviously the motors are now engaged. But when that's in, it should look like that. And then we need to put a cover over the top of that. So it's going to turn this around. So this is the cover that goes over the top of this. Now this was given to us in stage 45. Once again, we're just going to line all of these up. Make sure we're not pinching anything. Like that. And there we go, that's holding everything into place. We're going to be screwing in some screws, and they are 4506s. Again, they're the screws that came in stage 45. So we need four of these. That's one. And I'll do the other three. So when that's in place, it should look just like that. And that's all there is to do in that stage. Now, as you can see here, in stage 48, we're going to be starting to do the right aileron. God, I have problems with that word. We just need these two parts first here. So we've got this part here. So what we're going to do, just like last time, we've got these little metal sort of clips here, which are going to be going on each section here. I'm just going to line them up, because they sit just over the top of this here. So they go in this way, with the circle part facing in the opposite direction to these holes here. Here's the second one. You put the latch sort of like, it's got an open end which needs to go above. There we go. There. And the last one here just fits over the very end. I'm gonna try and put it in so you can see. That one's a little bit loose. There you go. We're then going to be putting this on top, which is going to keep all of these into place. Just like that, it's going to be held in with the screws that come in this one, which are 4807, looking like this. It's going to take four of these screws. And when they're in, they should look just like that. We've got a rod, metal rod to put through, so they're just going to go through the holes of each one of these. So one there, we'll do the middle one here, and finally the one at the end here. They should match up quite well. There you go. So now they're all in line, and once we've done that, we can just keep that to one side, because this is where the fun comes in. Now we're going to bring over what we've worked on last time, because we're now going to be attaching the other wing to this section just here. So holding it this way round, this is going to go over the four holes that we can see there. Putting this gear undercarriage just underneath that section there till it bites everything together just like this. There we go, perfect. And once again, we've got four screws now, which came with issue 44. To put these in, we've got one here, probably best to look at the pictures here. One this side, one here, and then the final one just here. Now I just want to see all of those wires are coming out okay there by the look of it. So when that's in, you know it's going to be okay because these gears on this side, you shouldn't have a wheel hanging down on its own. If you have, this one's slightly lower, but it's not too bad actually. On this side, if it is, then you've got a problem with your gears here that you're going to need to make sure that they're meshed correctly. So when we're happy with that, I'm just going to bring this over here because we're going to be installing the alien one. So the one we made earlier, looking like that, is just going to go into this section just there. And that's going to be held in by two of the screws that come in this stage. These are 4807 screws. They're the shorter silver ones here. And there we go, that one's two. So now that's fully installed there. And then just like last time, we're going to be piecing this together. So we're going to have the bottom aileron is going to go into this hole here, clipped in like that, into the parts that we've got just there, lining everything up. There we go. And then we're going to be gluing over the top this section just here. I'm just going to piece it in, doing a dry fit to see how this looks. And there we go. That's how that's going to look. No problems at all. As a matter of fact, look, when one turns, the other one turns. It's quite clever. Didn't even realize it did that. So when you're happy with how that's going to look, you're going to need to just prise it back apart again and put a little bit of super glue just on the lugs there. And when that's in place, it should look just like that. And that is all there is to do, probably on the side cameras best, in that stage. Now, I didn't realize it before, but it's definitely important that you do keep all your screws to the pack numbers, and that will help identify the screws. Now on the screen here, I've put a little picture that just shows you the difference between all the screws. So if you're having any problems, then refer back to this and you'll be able to see what screws you should be using. But that was issue 48. Let's do issue 49. So in issue 49, as you can see, we're going to start putting some of the support structure onto the wing. We've got this metal section here. It's the first thing we're going to need. So we're going to bring over the plane again. And that's just going to go over this section here. Just getting it all lined up. And it will fit into the trough of the skin here. Making sure it's below the line of the plastic here, that metal. And we're going to be putting that into place with some screws. And they are 4902 screws. They're like the silver flanged ones that we've got in this pack. Now it's going to take three of those. So we've got one here. That's down. This is really reinforcing the wing. I'm just put a clamp on there just to help hold that glue into place. It's doing a good job there, actually. I'll take that off in a second. Here's the second one. And finally, the third one is just all the way down the other end here. So I'm just going to move these wires just out the way for a second, like this, because we're going to be putting the skin, like we did on that side, on this side over here. So it's going to go over here and it's going to fit on these points around the wing. Now that's going to be held in with 4904 screws. Now remember, refer back to the instructions so you know which ones are what. Now it's going to be held in with six of those screws. So I'm going to start over this side and we'll get all of these in. So I'm going to do the two middle ones first. Excellent. I don't need this clamp on anymore. Again, just making sure I'm using the right screws. And I'll do the two at this end. And then finally, we've got one just in the middle here. And we've got one right at the very end over here. Perfect. A brilliant part now. We want to keep these wires here out the way. I don't know if I can train these at all. What I think I'm going to do, just for now, to keep them all together, I'm just going to put a cable tie around them. And that will keep them tidy for me. As you can see, so there's one there. And I'll do this side. Because what we're about to do now, something I've been waiting ages to do, is put the cockpit in. So, put a cable tie around this section as well. I can always take that off again afterwards. I just want to keep it tidy because I need to get the cockpit wire that's coming from the propeller there. And that's going to be going down this side and through these two points just there. Get my hand out of the way. You'll be able to see that. Like that. Bring over the cockpit. And as you can see, we've got our own wires coming out the cockpit here. And these wires we want coming through these two holes here and then out the back. So they're going to go this side. Get them in there. And then we're going to mount the cockpit onto here. Now this front top is going to go underneath that section there. So you want to install that section first so you can get that in. Just like that. Make sure you've got those wires where they're meant to be, which is impossible to show you that. And then when you're happy with how it looks, it should line up with the screw holes. There we go, that's perfect. On the plane there, you've got two just here. So 4903 screws, I've just put two in there to keep that into place. And we've got two which are quite hidden, but they are there at the front. And we'll secure those in as well. So four screws in total to put that in. Here's the front ones going in now. And there we go. That's the cockpit in. And that is all there is to do in that stage. How cool does that look? Now in stage 50 here, we're going to be assembling the tail gear retraction mechanism. So there's quite a few pieces on here. The first one we need is this frame here. This is made of plastic, just so you know. And we've got a clutch, which looks like that, which is just going to go into the center right here. There is a spindle for it to fit on. Looks like a Superman sign, but that's in place. On top of that, we're going to be putting the gear like this with this lip facing down. So that's going to go on top of the clutch like that. Then next to it, we've got a gear that looks like this. That's going to go into a spindle, which is in the pack here. Let me get that open in here. So we're going to put a spindle in the hole like that, and then put this gear with the teeth facing down to engage that one there. So that moves no problems at all. We're going to close that off with the top cover here, which is going to go on like this. That's going to bite all of those gears together so they can't move. And we've got a couple of screws which are labeled 5008, which look like that. They're just going to go into these two points here. So one here and one on the other side. And there we go, that's in place. Then on top of that gear here, we've got a little bit of plastic which looks like that. That's what it looks like from this side, but we'll want to put it in that side. So it goes over the top of this gear. It should engage with it. So again, when it turns now, that should turn, as you can see, like that. And that's going to be held in with one of the smaller screws with the flat heads, which look like that. Put that in from the top. And just get that all the way in. Just restricting it moving at the moment, so it is attached. So then when that turns, it looks like that. And that is all there is to do in that stage. Now in stage 51, we're going to be continuing on this retraction mechanism. So we've got a motor here. Once again, we're going to put the little cock over the top, matching it up with the line so it's in like that. This is going to be going into what we've just created here. I'm just going to move these over. So this way round, the motor is going to be going in here like that. Make sure that the wires are pretty much out the way. That looks pretty perfect to me, and it's going to be held in with the really tiny screws that we've got in this stage. Quite a quick stage, this one. Just putting a motor in. So one here. In the next few stages, we're going to get a chance to test all of these, but we'll do that when we come to it. Just make sure that's in place. And there we go. That's that stage complete. So in stage 52, we're going to be checking the servo motor here. And this is the servo motor that we've got there. We've got some other little points in this bag here, but we don't actually do anything in this stage. It's just basically saying, make sure you've got these. So I'll put that to one side and we'll bring up the last stage. Now the control board in this pack comes in a plastic case, but we don't actually use that in this stage. We're going to keep that to one side, but we do need the servo. I'm just going to attach the servo. So I'm going to bring that over here. I've kept that end in for the minute, but put the servo in just like this. So it's all the way down. We're going to hold that in with two of the small screws that come in this stage, held in from the top here. Then we're going to start piecing together the tail assembly, which means we need these two sections just here. Lots of little fine details in here. Get all of these parts out. And we're going to be putting it together like you see in this picture here. So this bit is going to go on the top like that. Then we've got a wheel, which is going right on the very end here. Just like that. And then we're just going to piece both of these together. Now, it is going to need a little tiny bit of super glue on here. So I'm going to put some glue just on the lugs. Did you hear that click then? That's going to ensure that that's completely together like that. We've got a cylinder tube to put in, which looks like that. That's just going to go down that rod that we've just installed first, like this. There we go. And then we've got this section here that we're going to be piecing together to hold all of this into place. So the axle of this section is going to go through that larger hole there. And then the cylinder is going to go into the smaller hole at the top. So it's like that. And then once that's in, we'll piece that together with the other side. You heard that click again. And then when that moves, pretty good articulation there. You can see the pistons going in and out there. That's excellent. Now we're going to hold that together with two of the screws that we've got here. These are the larger ones where we've got a pack of three of. One in the top. Excellent. And one at the bottom. And then on this section here, we've got the tail gear support to put on. That just goes over the top of that. Now it is shaped, so it can only go in one way. There we go. And that's fit on perfectly like that. Now we want to make sure that it's all the way in that hole. So you're going to need to push it quite hard to get it all the way in. There we go, and it should sit so you can see it out the other side there. But there we go, that's in completely there now. So when that goes up, you can see it's going to be operated as that's turning. Excellent. Now once again, we've got a tiny screw just to put in to keep that in place. All the way in there. There we go. Still operates. Excellent. And then we've got a clamp here just to put on the back section. We have got a locating lug, which is going to help us put that in like that. And we've got two of these medium sized screws just to put in here. to lock that into place. And there we go. That's the bracket in place. And that is all there is to do in that stage. And that's all there is to do in that pack. Wow. Pack 6. Pretty amazing. But once again, if you want to get this for yourself, I'll put the link down the bottom here to the Agora Models website. You can build up to where I am at the moment. But I really hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.